Today I'm going to be showing you the best and one of the most easiest strategies that you can apply and start downloading money like never before. Stay tuned. Yo, what's up? It's your boy Disamutupia. Thank you so much for tuning on to my YouTube videos. I'm going to tell you a little story about me just so you understand where I come from, where it is that I'm going. So I've been trading for like what? I'm 3 years currently and I've been in the business world for like close to 8 years. So basically whatever statements that I'm going to be making is things that I have already experienced within the forex trading industry and also the business industry. So now on today's video, I don't want to be speaking much about that. I want to be touching a bit more on what it is that I'm going to be focusing on today's video. I'm going to be actually speaking about the easiest forex strategies that most people ask me about, because I see in the comment box, guys, I do go through the comment box and then I see what you guys want. I even get to respond some of you guys' comments, which is amazing. Make sure to just keep on dropping those comments just so I can be able to get back to you. But I'm going to be speaking a bit more about giving you guys a simple yet powerful strategy that you can apply into your trading journey that will just allow you to download money just like that. You know, I've used this before and just that, like, once I started getting like a bit more experience, started evolving the strategy and I started just understanding on how to apply it in a much more profitable, highly profitable way. So in today's video, I'm gonna dive in a bit more deep on how you guys can just take the basics of it, understand it. I'm going to show you guys all of that. We're going to jump onto the charts and then we are going to be looking at what it is that I'm speaking about of this strategy and why it is so powerful. Please do stay tuned. Make sure to like this video. Make sure to also hit the subscribe button right now and then let us just start off first with the video. Before we jump onto the charts, I want people that don't know me to understand me a bit more better. So I'm going to give you guys a little background story of myself. So I started trading with an account type. My account balance was actually $22. I was able to grow it like up by $10. The next day I blew it. So basically what I'm saying is that I've blew my account several times. Not only one time, but I think it was like 3 times or 4 times, something like that. I've blew my account. Even when I just started trading Nasdaq, I was a bit more experienced. I was way too experienced in the currency world. But I even blew my Nasdaq account. So I just wanted you guys to understand that there's actually a negative side to things and there's also a positive side to things. Positive side is that I've made back the money that I blew. I've made even more than that. So it's exciting. And I've been in the currency world for more than 3 years currently, to be honest. And it's been amazing to, without a joke, it's been amazing. I see a lot of improvements daily. So on today's video, basically, I just want us to speak a bit more about this simple strategy that I want you guys to apply into your trading life. Like, it's actually a strategy that consists of support and resistance. But I understand that most people use the support and the resistance in the wrong way. What is it that I mean? So what an average trader does is that they actually use data coming from like years ago, even months ago, on which that data is actually a bit more incorrect because it happened a few years ago. But yes, you know, I can't say that, oh, it's not possible to use data that already didn't happen, but it's actually possible to use the most recent data, such as like the previous highs or the previous lows, the previous support or the previous resistance, in order to just see where the next zones are going to be at. So that's one thing that I want to be doing. And most importantly, this is actually going to help you be able to understand the fact that using this method, you'd be able to just understand if this is going to bounce or be a breakout. And which is why I'm going to actually tune into or tell you guys a bit more about the touches and the bounces, which ones are much more effective and how many touches you actually need to expect from the markets in order to actually look for the breakout, or how many touches you should just wait for in order to at least experience like a retracement. So stay tuned. Like, let us jump onto the charts and then let us see what it is that I actually have been looking or waiting forward to showing you guys about this method.
Wrong side of doing it. So this is what's going to happen. I'm going to show you guys the negative side of doing it, like how to not do it properly, and then I'm going to show you you guys the positive side of doing it, like how to actually do it properly. And then I'm going to dive in a bit more on speaking about the touches, when to expect the breakout using this method, and then I'm going to end it off with you just understanding on how to apply this. So I remember once done a video where I was showing you guys why normally I don't use support and resistance, né? So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to just throw down these lines each and everywhere, so you'd be able to just see that, like, I just threw it each and everywhere. So let me just do this. Okay, let me just move this a bit here, just so it's a bit more faster. As you can see, I'm not looking for some sort of support or resistance. I'm just literally throwing these on the charts. Okay, I'm just throwing these on the charts. Okay, so I think this is enough. I don't want my charts to be like this. Normally I'd see a lot of people's charts would be like this, né? whereby just look at, take a look at this this line, let me not even say resistance, this line, you can simply see that it was a resistance here, it was a resistance here, and so on. Even here, it was a resistance here, resistance here, it was a resistance here, it was a support here, you understand? So even this one here, I just threw it automatically, but you can see that it gave us a resistance here, resistance here, resistance here, support here, support here, support here, do you understand? This one here, resistance, support, and so on. Like basically each and every chart or each and every line that I just threw here randomly, even this one here, support, resistance, support, resistance. Do you understand? So basically what I'm trying to show you guys is that, support and resistance will always be everywhere. Do you understand? There will always be support and resistance everywhere. So if you try to use that method, basically it will just end up misleading you, because these things are everywhere. You get them each and everywhere on the charts. So now, okay, what is it that I mean? The best way that I can say you to apply these types of method, like using support and resistance, is that you should actually use the most recent price. Now, so for instance, let's say now, if this is like, okay, let me use this real quick. If this is your lower high, this is your lower high, and this is now your recent lower high, and this is your recent lower high, as you can see. And now, since you can see this is your lower high, lower high, lower high, this is your lower high, né? One thing that I want to show you guys is that, like, since you can see that this is actually a lower high, and this, like, price is now moving in a corrective manner. So let's say we are able to spot out that this is a correction, I don't know, a pattern, any type of a pattern, doesn't have to be a perfect pattern. Okay, this, oh, it's even giving us a cleaner pattern right here. There we go. Yeah, it's a beautiful pattern even. I wasn't expecting this. But if you're actually looking for something like this, you need a lot of things that actually back it up with. So basically, like, let's say, can see this is our lower high, this is our lower high, and this is our lower high. Okay, then price started moving upwards in a corrective manner. This is a correction, which means that it will end up breaking to the downside and price has to go downwards. So one thing that you do is that the way to apply support and resistance is that you need to actually take a look at the previous, the most recent lower high, and then you can just put your line up here, or it can even be a box. Okay, box, just like this. Okay, there we go, a box just like this. So normally with my boxes, one thing that I like to do is that I like to put the box in like in a manner whereby it's actually from the toppest or the lowest part of the week, the shadow, up until where the body starts. So it just allows me to see how big of a zone there is. Like, let's say for instance, if you see big rejections, that means that there's actually a critical zone, so it's actually going to give you a much more bigger zone. But if it's actually a smaller rejection, it will just give you a small zone. So this one here is a beautiful zone, bigger one. So it's exciting to just see that this is actually a beautiful zone. So most people also, one thing that they'll do is that they'll forget out these weeks, these zones, and then they'll just focus on the body, on which, yes, it's true. But let's say if you're placing a trade and then you're placing where the body is at, you might find out that that same chart or pattern is going to give you a week, and then that week is actually going to take you out on stop loss and then continue going downwards. Instead, if you drew your resistance or support according to the weeks, you'd be able to see that normally the market would make such weeks, and then this is how much that I can be expecting to put my stop loss in, and so on. So just by zooming in onto this section, okay, I hope this is enough. There we go. Can I just do this? So okay, I think it'll fit in. Yeah. Okay, as you can see, this is what I've done. I covered my zone. This is actually my most recent lower high. So basically what I'm saying is that I don't want price to break these highs. If price happens to break these highs here, if it happens to break these highs, it means that I'm going to start looking for something different. It means that now it's a change of trend, you know. This correction that I once thought was a correction means that it has now failed. It's no longer a correction. So obviously, also price, I'm going to start according to my trend lines here, the one that I've got here. But let me not speak a bit more about trend lines. There's a bit more deeper level whereby I speak about multi-touch confirmation. There's actually a much more powerful strategy that you can apply. Let's say the one where I speak about multi-touch confirmations. It's actually one of the strategies. It's not even like one of the strategy, because it's part of the strategy that I teach in the Forex Jesus 2.0. But let me not speak a bit more about that. Let me speak about the most simplest and easiest strategy that you can apply. Okay, so since this is your lower high, I'm saying this because I understand that you already know what higher highs are and what lower highs are. So this, since this is your lower high, can simply see that obviously now one thing that we're expecting is that for the market to at least push up at least somewhere till year, and then we're going to start looking for sells. But it's not really that simple, you know. One thing that you need to do is that the market, yes, sometimes it can go up here, give you whatever that you wanted, and then go down. But other times, one thing that it can do is that instead of coming all the way to here, it can just retrace somewhere between here and then go back down. So it's very important of you to actually know what you're looking for. That's why, like, it's actually not where the market is at. It's not about where the market is at, support or resistance. It's actually about how it gets there. So let us take a look at this movement. So let me just go back onto the 1 hour and see how we'd be able to spot out this trade. So now with this one, for instance, obviously you can simply see how price started pushing towards the zone. Our zone is like somewhere here, but you can see how the market started pushing towards the zone. So understanding this, you'd normally see a pattern that has presented itself somewhere here. And one thing that I like is that you'd obviously see also this section. Okay, let me use this section, and then this price pushed a bit more to the upside, But now most people, this could easily be seen as a double top, but most people couldn't have seen this because they don't understand what we actually speak about, which is like the mass psychology of things, whereby the market can give you one, two, three at a specific point, but because it wants to catch the ones on the wrong side, it wants to catch, let's say the ones that already sold, it wants to take them out of stop loss, and the ones that already bought, it wants to actually activate them and then hit them out on stop loss. So the market wants to win in both ways. So mostly people won't be able to get this. At this time, you should already be looking for sales because we are approaching a zone. The market is moving towards that zone in a corrective manner. So basically, we are approaching a resistance, and the market is moving towards this resistance in a correction or a corrective manner, on which this is actually way more than a lot. It's too powerful to actually apply. Like, understanding this, you'd be able to just see that, okay, already you're expecting sales. Obviously, you would have wanted it to push a bit more to the upsides. Okay, I would have had something like this, and at least like maybe one good thing would be it coming all the way to the upside, coming maybe till here. Then I'll take a sell, put it just some my stop loss, obviously not more than 30 pips, and then come all the way down to here. This would normally be my target, and obviously it depends on how the market moves. You can easily see that also some type of an entry would be you having a sell stop just below where the market breaks this beautiful pattern, because this pattern actually represents a rising wedge. And a rising wedge means that we have to go downwards. So remember, it's not just on how it's not what I said, it's not just about being a support or resistance. It's actually about how it gets there. It got to a resistance zone in a rising wedge. That's something powerful. You need to apply this, and then this is actually what happened afterwards. But let me not speak much about this. This is actually the one side that I want to show you. I want to also show you on NASDAQ one thing that I was experiencing. We caught a beautiful trade yesterday. I'll try to put up the results somewhere here for you guys, and you'd be able to just see that we caught a beautiful trade yesterday. Can you just do this? I'm on the 16 minute time, and I actually used this exact same method, né? Okay, I used this exact same method. So now it's actually in a way whereby I want us to actually come up with possible scenarios together. But take a look at this. Price started pushing down upwards. Okay, I think it was like a few days ago I spoke about this being at the third touch. You can see first touch here, second touch, third touch. So it's at the third touch. One of the most profitable ways I show you on how to capitalize on the market in the Forex Chaser 2.0, these touches. So you can simply see that. So we're expecting obviously a buy move all the way to the upside. Yeah? Just after that, I was able to spot this beautiful trade right here. Okay, I'm asking myself why the charts are so small, because I didn't use the 15 minute, I used the 1 hour. Okay, but let me just go back to it. There we go. So I had something like this. Price pushed upwards. I had this as my resistance zone to just allow me to see what it is that I can expect. Yeah? Okay, what it is that I can expect. So price pushed upwards, it broke this resistance zone impulsively, and I'm looking for buys, which is amazing because it means that now I know what I'm looking for. I'm looking for a buy move. So I started waiting for at least a correction, and also this previous resistance turning into support. And as you can see here, price started pushing downwards, gave us this beautiful pattern right here, and then I started taking a place my cells, I mean my buys here. Like literally I caught it at the week, and then I sent it also in the Signal group whereby they'll be able to capitalize on it, ne? And then we went a bit more to the upside with it. Price started pushing downwards. Okay, I think it was like maybe, yeah, okay, I know we, I experienced this move. I think we took some profits close to year, somewhere close to year on my one other account. And on my other account, one thing that I've done is that I only placed my stop loss at entry at break even to just let it, because one thing that I believed is that price had to push all the way to the upside. Ne? So I wanted price to push all the way to the upside, but now that didn't happen. So you can understand that all the profits that I was holding, I just gave it back to the markets. Luckily, it didn't take me out with negatives, but I'm also on the other account. Luckily, I was able to just go out with a few profits from that. But the most important thing is that I was able to see this previous support resistance zone breaking and then now turning into support. Then I was able to just capitalize a bit more on it to make things a bit more simple. So you can even see using this method, let's say just you bought somewhere here, then your stop loss was like way below. Obviously, you wait for confirmation. So let's say we experience this candle confirmation. This engulfing candle, okay, this is disturbing me. This engulfing candle right here, stop loss would be just a few, yeah. And obviously you'd have your targets be right here at the thing, at the highest point on which this is actually a very small target. We normally always target way more than this. Like my target was all the way up there. But you can simply see that a 2.2% is actually what you're looking for, which is amazing. So now one thing that I'm experiencing on this is actually this move that's playing out right here, okay. Can simply see that, okay, let me just remove this real quick. Can simply see that now price pushed downwards here. It pushed, this is the one that took me out with break even and stuff, pushed downwards, and then it started pushing a bit more to the upside, and it started pushing a bit more to the upside. But now what's interesting is that, okay, take a look at this, what I had. And I had this beautiful thing, remember, say from the week up until the body, where the body starts, I had this beautiful, and then it came, gave us support, it broke down impulsively. Remember, breakouts are actually much more better or much more strong when they're breaking out impulsively. Broke out impulsively and then it started correcting upwards. So this is actually a bit more trickier situation, because one thing from the type of strategy that I trade, one thing that I should be looking for here is actually a sell position. So because on NASDAQ, you know, I've been saying that I buy NASDAQ. I've seen a lot of sell opportunities on NASDAQ, but I just didn't take them. Remember, I spoke about, I think it was like this, and I think it was like somewhere I saw a beautiful set opportunity, but I just didn't take it because on the sell side, I don't know where the potential is going up until, you know what I'm saying? So I don't have a fully overall target for the sell side, but I know for the upside, there's a lot of potential on the market going to the upside and the targets that I'm actually looking and hoping to get. So I'll just keep on buying up until it gets to that point. But obviously, it doesn't mean that like I'll just buy and then hit stop and then buy and then hit stop and so on. Obviously, like I'll be taking calculated trades, and obviously at the same time, I'll just be holding some of my trades, meaning that like I'll just buy, hold it, and then the more it'll go to the upside, that means I'm a bit more to the right side, and then I'll just try to scale in, try to lock in for profits. But at the same time, if I buy and then it goes on the negative side, I'll just wait to see what actually happens up until there comes a time whereby the market is saying this is a perfect sell. Sell and just see if you can make money from selling, because I've never sold NASDAQ before. So can simply see that here price pushed upwards in a corrective manner, and it gave us this beautiful candlestick that rejected, on which normally my type of signal should is saying that this is a sell opportunity, né? This is where I would have my sell signal. My stop loss would be here and my targets would be here. This is actually how 12% on just the single trade. But because of NASDAQ, you know, I'm a bit more new on NASDAQ, even though I've made a few profits on it. I'm not really too comfortable with just placing trades that I like with the type of normal strategy that I utilize. You know, my strategy is very powerful, but I need to understand NASDAQ a bit more better with the strategies that I'm still learning while I'm trading it, because at least I'm trading it with Life Account. So it means that like when I'm learning, the losses that I make, I learn from them. I take a lot of lessons from them, and the profits that I make, I actually take a lot of lessons from them. So this is actually a powerful move that we need to take a look at. You can simply see price as soon as it got here, started correcting a bit. See how it approached to the upside, so it can push downwards a bit. Or one thing that can happen is that price, the only time I'll take a buy is when the price breaks up, then comes back to retest, and then it goes to the upside. Because still, guys, let's focus on the fact that this didn't break the previous higher lows. This is the higher low. It didn't break the previous higher lows. So which means that it's still going to the upside. But this is actually one of the best ways you can actually apply the support and resistance method. And I know that I actually spoke about the fact that like using these touches, you know, using these touches can be very powerful. So let's say taking a look at it, just to be brief, because I don't like wasting a lot of time. Let's say if you have a resistance support here. Okay, since it's a support, let's put it down here. And maybe a resistance, maybe make this bit red. There we go. Resistance up here. So normally, like if price comes and then it pushes, let's say the first touch, okay, forms this, then comes back down maybe on the support area, and then pushes a bit more. Okay, depends on you guys know how the market moves, it's not too clear. Okay. So let's say normally one thing that I'll do is that this way I would have my resistance. This is showing me this is my previous lower high is. So I'll have my resistance here, and this is gonna guide me on what's about to happen next. And then one thing that I'll be expecting now is not a breakout. I won't be expecting a breakout so soon. It doesn't even have to be a perfect retrace. It doesn't have to retrace once it gets. It can be a double top, can break a bit and then go down, or you can just retrace where it's at now. So this is one thing that I'll be expecting. Okay. And this is the second touch. Now, one thing that I like is that normally with second touches, you can start, let's say on the support, with second touches, you can start placing your buys. But with third touches, you can actually, on the resistance too, with second touches, you can start placing your buys. Sorry about that. Okay. And then let's say price pushes down on support, place your buys. And normally, I notice that, yes, you can experience one last touch, which is the third touch, but after third touches, price has to either break out to the downside or to the upside. So now that depends on what pattern it is. So what it is that I mean, what depends on what pattern it is.
So basically, when I say that it depends on a different pattern or what type of a pattern there is, it means that, like, basically, if you take a look at it, an ascending type pattern means that they eventually break to the downside, and a descending type pattern, it means that they eventually break to the upside. So looking at the pattern, the type of pattern that you are involved in, and then the type of the way the market is moving, you'll be able to anticipate that the next breakout is more likely to be to the upside, and you'll be able to anticipate that the next breakout is either more likely to be to the downside. Do you understand what I'm saying? So with this, you'd be able to know when to expect that breakout. This is one of the most powerful tools that I actually teach in the Forex Jesus 2.0, being able to understand the types of the market conditions, being able to understand how the market structure actually works and how it moves and how to expect this breakout. You know, this is actually the multi-touch confirmation. And one thing that I like about it is that you'd be able to know that, okay, now it's the fourth touch, because normally with the first, second and third, that's where the support or resistance is a bit more stronger. But once it becomes more than three touches, it's weak. It's becoming much more weaker, which means that there's a higher chances of it breaking. Just like you, let's say if you happen to punch this wall multiple times, you know, let's say if you punch it once, even though you're punching it with a lot of power, it's not gonna break as it would break after you punch it 10 times or even 50 times. If your hand obviously doesn't break, there's a higher chances of the wall a bit cracking, you understand? So it means that the more it touches that specific zone, the more weaker it gets. Hope you understand that. Yo guys, and I understand that a few of you guys are a bit more skeptical of understanding the whole purpose of the 2.0 mentorship program that I have. Like normally, one thing that I'd like to dive in a bit more deep into is these live sessions that each and every Sunday we dive, we actually look at the market together, you know. Well, that's one thing that I like about it. And one thing that also helps out a lot is that the fact that I'm able to dive into a bit more deeper information that you'd understand, instead of just showing you the way the support, the resistance work, instead of just showing you just how to apply these things, I actually walk through alongside with you to be able to just literally see how it works, how to apply them. I walk down with you. I've got people in the group that are actually there to help you out for real. I've got mentors that are let's say when you don't understand, you'd be able to just assign one-on-one sessions with them. There's actually a lot of benefits that you can get from just being in the group or in the premium team, because I'll just put a lot of pictures or testimonials from members that are actually in the group right now experiencing profits. And one thing that I like is that if one of us takes losses, most of us are going to take losses too, because we all literally trade one of the same types of setup and strategies. And if one of us takes profits, then most of us are more likely to make profits, which makes it a win-win situation for all of us. It's much more beautiful to see a team always together, you know, sharing ideas, like-minded people and all these types of information that you need. And by the way, I just want to show you guys a little something real quick. I played around with the Forex Jesus website. Yeah, and it looks beautiful. Like, just take a look at this, ne? Okay, this is the update that I done. Can simply see that it's a black color and it's looking beautiful. Okay, it's looking beautiful. You guys can do something simple. Just go to Forex Jesus. I'll put the link below. Actually, I'll put the link below because it's actually a much more longer link. Then you can just check out this this website. You know, just check out the page. Check out the benefits of the Forex Jesus 2.0 mentorship program. You'd be able to just get something that you need. You know, because that's where I dive a bit deep about these methods. You know, this method that I just showed you now. It's actually one of the most basic method that I started with. I started trading with understanding the Forex market at the beginning of my years, but I started me a bit more profitable. Understanding on how I evolved or evolving it into a much more better structurized method, and then now I started including things such as multi-touch confirmation. I started understanding when to expect breakouts. I started understanding patterns, and I started to be able to forecast and come up with possible scenarios in the near future. So that actually allowed me to evolve. So that's one thing that I do. Like, literally the 2.0 course like takes you from the beginner level, being able to not know what the Forex market is. Actually, if you are still at the beginner level, I've got a free training for you. I'll just put the link down in the description box whereby you'd be able to see the training. But it takes you from like a very basic level up until you understand, up until you start to make consistent profits. And then at the end, we teach you how you can start keeping those profits, you know, so you don't just make money, but you keep that money too. That's the whole purpose of the 2.0 course. Right, and one thing that I'll do is that I'll just also try to put the link somewhere up here whereby you'd be able to just click it. It will take you straight up to the 2.0 course, like whereby you'd be able to just read more about it. It's very, very much important to understand and read more about it. See what other people have to say. See if it's working out for other people, because if it is working out for more people, it's more likely to work out for you, because, you know, we are all human beings. We are all normal at the end of the day. And one thing that I'll say is that if you like the types of videos that I share, one thing that I'll do is that I'll just try to put the video somewhere up here, and then you can just press it and then take it to my next channels. But thank you so much for watching. Make sure to hit the subscribe button and like this video.